The four-time defending national champion Georgia Gym Dogs are in the midst of a gymnastics dynasty, led by legendary coach Suzanne Yocklin of 26 years and senior Courtney Coupetz, a 10-time All-American. They are both looking to vault the Dogs to another title. However, Alabama will turn to their own star in Morgan Dennis to keep things rolling for the Tide and spring the upset in Athens. Up next, Bama versus Georgia. Welcome inside the Stegman Coliseum here on the campus of the University of Georgia in Athens, Georgia. I'm Bart Conner along with Kathy Johnson Clark. Today we'll be calling the action as the University of Georgia Gym Dogs play host to the Crimson Tide of Alabama. There is Sadr Patterson in her 31st year, four-time NCAA team champions, and what a record she has amassed as the head coach of the University of Alabama. There is Suzanne Yocklin, the iconic coach in her 26th and final season here at the University of Georgia. They have won 9 NCAA team titles. They have won the last 4 back-to-back, and their goal is to try to make it 5 straight in 2009. Nearly 10,000 people on hand, and of course the Gym Dogs are pumped up anytime they host Alabama. We're in for some exciting action. Kathy Johnson-Clark, a pleasure to be working with you as always. First up will be Hillary Morrow. She's a sophomore out of Boston, Massachusetts, did most of her pre-collegiate training at the Cincinnati Gymnastics Academy. She's expected to compete on vault, beam, and floor tonight.
All of the Georgia gymnasts are competing a 10-0 start value vault. Yurchenko laid out with a full twist.
Good technique.
Very good technique, not a perfect landing. I think we'll start to see more landings better as the competition goes on and certainly as the season progresses. It's one of the hardest things to train, these hard landings, especially on gymnasts who have been in the sport for years and years.
It's going to be fast and furious. Ricky Levigern, first up from Alabama on the bars. We go back and forth. Georgia opening up on the vault. Alabama opening up on the bar.
And Bart, Ricky has been a rock for Alabama, competing in the all-around in both the first two competitions, hitting every single event for them.
She's a junior out of Annandale, Virginia. Did her pre-collegiate competition at Capital Gymnastics.
And this is the kind of routine you want to start off with. Very, very solid routine. Good landing.
Well, Alabama knows that they have to be nearly perfect if they're going to challenge Georgia at home. Especially Georgia on something of a mission this year to win their 5th in a row. Lauren Sessler will be the second vaulter. Score for Hillary Morrow was a 9.
It's out of a 10.0.
Here is Brittany McGee, out of Arlington, Texas, did her pre-collegiate gymnastics at Texas Dreams under Kim Zemeskal, the former world champion back in 1991, and her husband Chris Burdett.
Wow, she really stalled that out. It did not look like she was going to turn that over. Good amplitude on the pack salto down, transitioning to the low bar.
Alabama team struggling with several injuries preseason and into the early part of this season. They're pretty beat up already.
Both Sarah and Dave said that they were really going to build this year. They've got to start out kind of slow and build as the season progresses. Good, solid routine. But she really stalled that all. Almost didn't turn it over.
Score for Lauren Sessler was a 9.75. This is Cassidy McComb.
1.5 twists, much more difficult vault. Again, it scored from a 10.0. She had the hop to the side. Unfortunately, she'll get a deduction for the hop as well as being offline.
Combe is a sophomore out of Henderson, Nevada. Expected to compete in 3 events tonight.
This is Georgia's 4th meet. This early in the season, they've gone back to back to back with the competition.
Here is Morgan Dennis. She's the junior all-arounder. originally from West Hampton, New Jersey, National Honor Society, and she is a star on every level for the Alabama Crimson Tide.
Second team All-American on this event. She's just solid all the way around. Nice height on the release move. Good position in the handstand.
The score for Brittany McGee was a 9.775, so Alabama off to a very good start on bars.
First day, very nicely done. Strong routine.
The score, by the way, for Cassie DeMacomb, Georgia, on the vault was a 9.8. As you look at a quick replay here of Morgan Dennis. And we'll be back with more gymnastics action. Welcome back to Stegman Coliseum in Athens, Georgia. Geralyn Stack-Eaton now up for Alabama on the bars. The score for Morgan Dennis was a 9.825.
And Geralyn is one of the freshmen that have really stepped in and done a lot for the team right off the bat. Very nice form on this event. Legs straight, toes kind of extremely clean.
You mentioned the freshmen. About a third of the scores we're counting tonight for Alabama will come from freshmen, so they are counting on a lot of youth to hold up under this pressure here in Georgia.
It's amazing, and they're coming through.
Here is Courtney Coupetz. We talked with her about how she healed so quickly from an Achilles tendon tear.
You know, when they tell me you can't walk on it, I won't walk on it. I want to make sure I do the best things that I can do to get back in the least amount of time. And so I think with that kind of attitude, it kind of helps a little bit as well.
The superstar of the Gym Dogs, no question about it.
Just a gorgeous gymnast. Oh, a big hop. She nailed one in warm-ups and really wanted to do it in the competition.
10-time All-American. She's come back from two torn Achilles tendons. And to see her at this level just 11 months from that major injury is remarkable, Kathy.
It is amazing. I mean, her comeback has been superb. I know she wanted to stick the landing, but the vault was huge.
What can you say about Courtney Coupetz, world champion member, two-time Olympic medalist? She has been a real solid force for this team for the last several years, and she could lead them to their fifth in a row. If it's going to happen, it's going to be on the shoulders of Courtney Coupetz.
She's just so tough.
Cassie Price to the bars for Alabama.
I like watching this gymnast in warm-up. She's very serious, very intent on doing well for the team.
Price herself coming back from an injury, had a wrist injury. Expected to only do two events tonight.
Good strong distance, little bit of bent knees in that double layout. Nice position and obviously quite happy with it.
The young lady is a six-time member of the national team, so she's had lots of national and international experience. As we go back to Georgia on the vault, Tiffany Tournay, their final vaulter. The score for Courtney Coupetz was a 9.875.
And what an athlete Tiffany is. She is so powerful, strong, springy. One and a half, she threw it. They were trying to decide whether to throw the full twist or the one and a half. She went for the harder vault, little short on that landing. She can do that vault much, much better, but she did pull it out.
She is the senior out of Grapevine, Texas, and one of their all-around superstars, no question about it. What a strong athlete.
She has an injury that she's just going to deal with. She's a senior. She needs surgery, but there's no way for her to have it and come back. So they actually gave her an injection just for the pain because she can't hurt it anymore. Just a little piece of bone that kind of floats around.
That's where that leg causes
some pain.
Final performer, Ashley Priest for Alabama on the bars. Alabama having a strong start on the bars.
SEC Freshman of the Week. She's another gymnast with a lot of national level experience, an elite gymnast. Very nice form on this event. Really shows off the handstand position. Very stretched position. Had to pipe that down just a little bit in the double layout.
The score for her teammate, by the way, was 9-8-7-5. When we come back, we'll have the score for Ashley Preece and the scores after the first of four rotations here in this SEC battle between Alabama and Georgia. Back inside the Stegman Coliseum here on the campus of the University of Georgia after the first of four rotations in this classic SEC battle. You can see Alabama off to a great start on the bars with a 0.3-point lead over Georgia. Here are the scores for the Georgia Bulldogs. Tiffany Tolnay, the final vaulter, had a 9.675. That score was dropped. And then for Alabama on the uneven bars, the final performer was Ashley Preece, a 9.875. A strong opening performance for the Crimson Tide. Hi, everybody. I'm Bart Conner, along with my fellow Olympic medalist, Kathy Johnson-Clark. And it's great to be working with you again, Kathy. Your impressions of the first rotation. Alabama very strong in the bars.
Well, they came at them with very clean, very organized bar routines. And Georgia, I was surprised. After watching the warm-ups, I expected bigger vaults with better landings. I did hear Suzanne say, you just need to settle down. It's early in the season, so I expect to see them get a little bit better as we go on.
Now, there's an overarching story all season long, of course, and that is Suzanne Yocklin's final year, her 26th year, and the first 5,000 people that show up tonight, of about 10,000 here in the building, get this statue. You think she'll autograph one for us?
I hope so.
She's kind of an iconic coach. If they could win their fifth in a row, it would be 10 total team titles. They would surpass the University of Utah as the most successful women's gymnastics team in NCAA history. Do you think they can do it?
Wow, absolutely, I think they can. Suzanne has done amazing things for women's collegiate gymnastics. Mm-hmm. It's phenomenal what she has built here. Most important, she says, I've built a program that I can walk away from, and it will continue with this tradition of winning because of her assistant coaches and the teams and just the whole philosophy that she has started.
Now, keep in mind, the last team to beat the University of Georgia in this building was Alabama, and that is the contestant tonight. So we could be in for an interesting battle. Like most of these SEC competitions, it usually comes down to the last athlete on the last event, and I expect it'll be that way tonight. We talked with Coach Patterson about how she feels competing against Georgia.
Our fans love to see Georgia. I think Georgia fans love to see Alabama. And this rivalry has added a great deal to women's gymnastics and women's sports in general. And I think anytime you can take something and build on it, it's important. And I love to compete in front of a crowd, whether they're cheering for us or against us. I would rather compete in front of an inspired crowd.
We'll move to the vault, the Georgia Gym Dogs on the uneven bars. First up for Alabama will be Geralyn Stack Eaton from Horsham, Pennsylvania, for her pre-collegiate gymnastics at the Parkettes program. She's just a freshman, former senior elite national team member.
And Bart, they built a little bit of momentum over at the uneven bars. Not a huge vault, a good landing. It looks like she landed a little bit short on that ankle. You really want to see the vault explode upward off from the platform.
Over to the bars now for Georgia, a freshman. This is Catherine Dean. She's a freshman out of Sparks, Nevada. She's doing just the uneven bars for the Gym Dogs tonight.
And unlike Alabama, they're only competing two freshmen in this competition, both on this event, the uneven bars.
To me, the make or break events in women's collegiate gymnastics are the balance beam, of course, and the uneven bars, because most teams are pretty good on vault and floor.
Strong routine to begin. We're not seeing those nailed landings that we really need to see to not give away the tenths of a point.
The first score for Alabama on the vault, 9.825 for Geralyn Stack Eaton. Rachel Terry now, she's another freshman.
Same vault as the previous one. And again, just level with the platform, not really blasting it up and showing that amplitude. You really need to see that to see the scores go into the 9.899 range.
Rachel Terry, a freshman out of Hoover, Alabama, stepping into the lineup for Sarah Patterson's Crimson Tide. They have one returning NCAA champion on the team. That, of course, is Morgan Dennis, their superstar. They returned five All-Americans from last year's SEC championship team, or regional championship team, excuse me. Marcia Newby now for Georgia on the bars. The score for her teammate, Catherine Ding, was a 9-8.
We'll see if Georgia can now settle down, which is exactly what Suzanne Yoffman told them. Between events, you just need to settle down.
Boy, does she swing big. Nice technique.
It takes so long to do the skill. She's very, very tall. Melissa Bennett, nice routine, almost had that stuff landing. Gave up a teeny tiny little step right there at the end.
Boy, there's a whole bunch of people on their feet.
That should be a huge boost for them. That's the kind of routine you need to really kickstart the momentum that they need to build right now. Very, very long swing, as you mentioned, Bart. Huge. Double layout at the end, piked down a little too much, and just over-rotated very slightly.
Brittany McGee now on the vault.
Pretty form, there's the landing that we're looking for. Did not move those feet.
Her teammate, by the way, Rachel Terry, had a 9.675, a little shorter rotation on her vault. This one was good, however.
Much better vault. Legs together, tight toes pointed throughout. She landed with the one foot slightly in front of the other, more as a style.
Gina Nuccio, the freshman out of Naperville, Illinois, now to the bars for the University of Georgia. Marcia Newby had a 9.875.
Throughout with toes and legs slightly coming apart.
Nuccio, the two-time junior Olympic champion.
Good dismount, though.
Georgia starts to pick up momentum. We'll be back with more gymnastics right after this. We're back. Alabama's on the vault now. Megan Mashburn.
What a great story.
Sophomore. What a great story. She worked her way onto the team as a walk-on.
Love to see this. Worked so hard. Worked herself into the vault lineup. Pike front half. That scores out of a 10.0. Oh, is she happy?
Coach Sarah Patterson talked about her. She said, she's the kind of kid I like to work with. She sort of worked her way into the lineup very successfully. One of those overachiever type athletes that Patterson is very proud of. Grace Taylor, the junior out of Aiken, South Carolina, will be on the bars for Georgia next. Gina Nuccio score a 9.875, so Georgia turning it up here on the bars.
Grace, a national champion on the balance beam, also very strong on this event.
Associate head coach Jay Clark said, we have 12 or 13 young ladies that could do routines that start from a 10.0. Very proud of their depth on this event, and that seems to be proving.
There's a move we don't see often, invented by your wife, Nadia Fominich.
She's pretty good, Jimmy.
Still a really hard move. Beautiful double layout.
I know you like Grace Taylor's technique and style, and her form is lovely, isn't it?
There it is. Really a hard move to put in your routine. It's hard to work into and out of, so it's nice to see.
To the vault now, Ricky Lebegern, the score for Megan Mashburn, a 9.675.
Oh, that's their most difficult vault so far, 1.5 twist. Little trouble on the landing, rather large step at the end, and not quite as high as you'd like to see the vault. But for this time of the year, I think she's happy with it. Got the twist around, there it is, 1.5 twist. And then the legs just buckled and really had to take that big step forward.
Tiffany Tolnay, we saw her with a little bit of a shaky landing on the vault, not what she expected, only a 9.675. See what she can deliver on the bars. Her teammate, Grace Taylor, a 9.875. So Georgia started with a 9.8, and they have three successive 9.875s following them up. Strong here.
And Bart, she could have played it safe over at vault and just done a full twist and nailed the landing. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of happy to see them go for more. Nice, very good amplitude.
It's kind of typical of Georgia philosophy. They don't hold back early in the year. Take on all the difficulty early in the year and see if you can handle the pressure.
It's the thing I think I'm most impressed with is the way that they have learned to handle pressure and actually thrive on it.
Jay Clark, the associate head coach, gives her high fives. Clark
hey,
will be taking over for Suzanne Yachtman when she retires at the end of this season. We asked Morgan if she's feeling pressure competing against Georgia.
I don't feel any pressure at all, and I'm so excited for tonight. I think all of us are really excited, and this is definitely a challenge, but none of us are going to back down, and we're just going to compete our hearts out.
Morgan Dennis will be the final vaulter for Alabama. Ricky Lebegern had a 9.85.
SEC champion on this event, ranked fourth in the nation. It's a huge vault, but of course not the perfect landing. Step up, that will be the deduction. I get the feeling that the gymnasts and coaches right now at this point in the season are very happy to just successfully complete the vaults. They'll get the landings down as the season progresses.
You really do have to pace yourself because you know, your ankles only have so many sticks in them, don't they? You want to save those for the championship.
The landings hurt.
9-9 was the score for Tiffany Tolnay. And an Olympic medalist is coming up next, Courtney Kupetz.
Just absolutely gorgeous on this event. Bronze medalist at the Olympic Games on this event. Extraordinary form, amplitude, difficulty. She has it all. She's the complete package here.
Nearly 10,000 people to their feet.
That was gorgeous.
That's what the Gym Dog fans are used to seeing from Courtney Kupetz, the 10-time All-American, comes back from a torn Achilles tendon, and does she nail it? The score is up for Courtney Kupetz, a perfect 10. This place is rocking.
Unbelievable. Just gorgeous routine, amazing comeback.
Let's take a look at one more time at that spectacular exercise, Kathy.
I mean, her feet are just glued together. Her legs so perfectly straight. Good handstand positions. Full over the bar, right into a release mode. So she's got the level of difficulty that surpasses most in collegiate gymnastics on this event. Perfect form and just a gorgeous landing.
And we're back on the campus of the University of Georgia. After two rotations, here are the team scores. Georgia has surged into the lead after a spectacular performance on the uneven bars, capped off by the perfect 10 by Courtney Kupetz. Alabama on the vault, their scores range between 9.675 and 9.875. And Georgia Bulldogs, their scores were spectacular. Their lowest score, a 9.8 on the bars, the highest, the perfect 10. Now to the balance beam. And the University of Georgia first performer. This is our first look at Paige Burns. She's a senior out of St. Cloud, Florida, from Orlando Metro Gymnastics. This is the only event she's scheduled to compete on tonight.
They had an excellent final touch warm-up on this event. Seems like they've really settled in, and that performance by Courtney Kupetz really elevated all of their energy, everything, and they just seem very focused during the warm-up on balance beam.
It really is amazing what one stuck landing can do to the spirit of a team.
Oh, well, good save.
Georgia currently ranked 5th in the country on the balance beam. They had some trouble in their first competition.
This is where they're really missing Courtney McCool, mm-hmm. who is out with a broken bone, navicular bone, in her foot. She would normally anchor this event.
This is the event that Suzanne Yonklin said prior to the season, this is going to be an interesting event to watch because we don't have the depth like we have on uneven bars. We're going to have to be mentally strong. Brittany McGee, the leadoff performer for Alabama on the floor. Three seniors on this team, which is also comprised of 6 juniors, 2 sophomores, and 6 freshmen. Talked a lot about Georgia's dominance. But let's not forget Alabama, 26 times in a row appearance at the NCAA championships.
And one of only 4 teams ever to win the national title.
21 individual NCAA champions came out of Alabama.
Nice, strong finish. Very nice choreography done by Dana Duckworth, who is now their assistant coach. She'd been a volunteer coach for the past 10 years. All new routines for Alabama. Very strong finish. Pike double back. She's such a clean gymnast. Very, very elegant.
Back to the beam now. The score for Paige Burns was a 9.725. Strong leadoff performance. Hillary Morrow up now.
Concentration slightly off on that, but really held on to the landing. Sure. All the others have been so solid. Double twist. Solid.
Morrow enters this meet ranked 15th in the country on the balance beam. Not a bad performance there. Remember, 6 athletes compete. The top 5 scores count towards the team total, so they have the buffer of 1 potential mistake, but certainly no more than that.
Caitlin Sullivan.
Caitlin Sullivan, the freshman out of Elkhart, Indiana. Up now for Alabama on the floor.
Ooh. Very off on that landing, and in fact went out of bounds, which is an additional 10th of a point deduction. Just a little too much juice.
Never go wrong with Sweet Home Alabama as your music.
Well, maybe
except
in Georgia.
You're in Georgia. Okay. I'm guessing it's a slightly different atmosphere when you do it. in Tuscaloosa in front of more than 15,000 fans. In fact, Alabama legendary for the attendance over there. They set many national marks in terms of attendance. In 2006, they averaged 12,578 people for every meet. Let's just say a polite smattering of applause in Athens, Georgia, however.
The good news is she could hear her music while she performed.
Back to the beam for Georgia. Hillary Morrow's score was a 9.825. Cassidy McComb. She had a 9.8 on the vault.
This is an event that Georgia has just been so tough on through the years, all the years that Suzanne has coached this team. Mental toughness, physical toughness, that's what she really tries to instill in them from the very beginning.
Who knew that a moonwalk could bring them to their feet? Kathy, when was the last time you've seen this in a beam routine?
I've seen it a few times through the years. I think what would be even more impressive is zero gravity.
Cassie Price now for Alabama on the floor.
In addition to the step, a few little deductions in that routine. Keep in mind, these are all new routines this season for Alabama. Right here, she landed on the line, but her toes look like they're just over the line, possibly.
Her score was 9.875 on the bars. Be a little bit lower there on the floor. Back to the beam now, Tiffany Tolnay of Georgia. Score for her teammate Cassidy McComb was a 9.825.
Tiffany has been such a strong all-around competitor every single year throughout her collegiate career.
Currently ranked fourth in the nation in the all-around.
An All-American on this event.
as well as in the all-around and even bars floor exercise. Just a fantastic collegiate career.
All-American, Tolnay. Pretty remarkable.
Good job. She seemed nervous, but handled it. Got through the routine.
Stopped. We might have to take that punch front out.
It's killing her foot.
It's killing her foot.
That was the look we saw on her face.
You heard Jay Clark say, we may have to take that punch front out. It's killing her foot. Many of these athletes dealing with injuries, and we move back over to the floor for Alabama. Ricky Lebegern with a 9.85 on the uneven bars and a 9.85 on the vault. So solid today so far.
You're more concerned with making the tumbling pass, landing on your feet, being safe.
We'll be right back with Alabama and Georgia after these messages. Georgia's on the beam with Grace Taylor, and she is spectacular on this event. Taylor, the junior out of Aiken, South Carolina.
A national champion this year, this past year, the year before second, so extremely consistent on this event. Last year played the role of leadoff on balance beam. Such a crucial role, that first gymnast up on the balance beam. She really is lovely here. From the choreography, her flexibility, poise. This is the type of routine a photographer would love because you can take so many nice pictures. Right here, look at that gorgeous flexibility. And she doesn't pass through any position that's not pretty.
This really is a complete routine, isn't it? The power and the athleticism, and yet the beauty and the grace. This is the whole package.
With the requirement of difficulty, she balances out nicely.
Her teammate Tiffany Tolnay had a 9.85, but we could be looking at a big score here, Kathy Johnson-Clark.
Very pretty. Nice control.
We've seen 110 tonight from Courtney Coupette on the bars. You got a lot of people in this building expecting a big score.
They've all given her a 10.
Where's Nick?
It'll be big. One judge gave her a 10, one a 9.95. One a 9.9.
Our score would be a 9.975 as we turn back over to the floor. Ashley Priest, Alabama. Her teammate Ricky Lebegern had a 9.7. Thank you. competing in three events, all but vault. So far, she had a 9.875 on bars, and we'll see her on the beam. Final rotation.
Best routine so far on floor. Nice choreography, very expressive dance.
The scores for Alabama on floor ranging between 9.4 and 9.75. Whereas Georgia on the beam is rocking, and guess who's up now? Courtney Kupetz. Her teammate Grace Taylor had a 9.975. One of the things I like about Coach Yocklin's philosophy is, I remember it in particular with Courtney Kupetz, when the kids want to do more difficult routines, she says, if you believe in yourself, if you think you can make it, then I'm backing you all the way. Go for the hard routine. That's the ultimate confidence a coach can give an athlete. At the same time, it's all about accountability. She says, if you think you can do it, then you do it. Show me what you got.
And yet she steps in when she needs to, because Courtney at first was opposed to doing this dismount. She wanted to do the round up double back, the harder dismount, but that was so hard on her body. They combined skills for that combination, the dismount, and look at the result.
Championship teams often come down to how well they do the beam.
Three skills right here: switch leg leap, gainer layout, and then right into the gainer off the side. Yes, the dismount is easier, but in combination, it's appealing. Strong routine.
They got what they expected. Another 10, her second tonight, Courtney Kupetz.
And I tell you what, Grace Taylor set that up. When she performs so well and so near perfect, coming close to that 10-0 mark, when Courtney came up, had not one little bobble, they had to go to 10. Wow.
Incredible.
Her first ever 10 on this event, and it's a hard event to score 10 on. Very easy to make little mistakes.
So far tonight, Kupetz with a 9.875 on vault and two 10s, and she's yet to go on the floor in the final rotation. Morgan Dennis, the superstar of Alabama, now hoping to deliver their biggest score there. Ashley Priest had a 9.85. The other scores have been rather mediocre for Alabama on the floor, down as low as 9.4.
Gorgeous double layout, nice big skill.
The greats from Alabama, you think of Ashley Miles, Endree Pickens, Penny Housechild, Jenna Rice, Dee Foster. Add Morgan Dennis to that list, because she will go down in history as one of the more successful Alabama gymnasts. The score for Morgan Dennis and the standings after three or four rotations in this battle between Georgia and Alabama. Well, Kathy Johnson-Clark, what a day we're having here in Athens, Georgia. Two 10s in a row. This is the first one for Courtney Kupetz on the bars.
Just spectacular back-to-back routines from Courtney. Two typically strong events, but to do them both in the same competition with no breaks, and just everything you need to be fantastic. She came through with and a picture-perfect landing.
The last gymnast from Georgia to score two 10s in one meet was Chelsea Bird. She did it in 2004 versus LSU on floor and vault. This is on bars and beam.
And this is the hardest event to score a 10 on. There is no room for error. It's so easy to have one little squirm, tiny, tiny mistake.
One quick reminder, it was just 11 months ago that she completely tore her Achilles tendon.
That's just unreal to me. I'm just thrilled to see her back in competition, to see her in this kind of form, and then so competitive. To strive for perfection, not just hitting your routine for your team.
The team motto for 2009 is all in for 10, according to Coach Yockley.
All in, meaning all the alums and all the fans and all the athletes and just the history and the tradition that we were all going to be in for 10. And then also, of course, the fact that the number 10 does represent perfection in gymnastics. So it's not just the 10th championship, but it is the perfection that we're all in for.
Here we are through the third rotation of four. You see the scores there. Georgia 147.975 over Alabama 147.025. So by just less than a point, the Georgia Gym Dogs capped by that 10.0 by Courtney Coupettes were just spectacular on the most perilous of all women's gymnastics events, the beam. The Crimson Tide over on the floor. Their scores started out mediocre, but they finished with two strong 9.85s from Priest and Dennis. Suzanne Yocklin very happy with her team performance on the beam. You can see they've lightened up a lot since the first rotation in vault, where they didn't quite seem to be clicking, did they?
No, not at all. A very lackluster performance on vault, especially compared to their warm-up. So it was nice to see them turn it around. And, of course, Courtney Coupettes just really launched them into a new place.
For Georgia, they will finish on the floor. Alabama now to the balance beam. You must say, for Georgia, the home team, to have the lead and to go into floor, they're feeling really confident now. Brittany McGee, the first performer for Alabama on the beam.
Now, it's interesting because Alabama right now is ranked number one on this event. This is a strong event for them. They can score big if they go after it. Beautiful pass. I love that. One arm back handspring right into a layout.
Sarah Patterson very pleased with their depth on this event. Brittany McGee on vault had a 9.875, 9.775 on the bars, and a 9.75 on floor, so pretty solid today.
I would love to see them come up with big marks here on this event. Started off strong on the uneven bars, their first rotation. Good vault. Struggled a little bit on the floor exercise with just landings. Going out of bounds, giving up tenths of a point there. This was gorgeous, absolutely gorgeous routine. Very smooth, elegant, good difficulty.
Alabama, they told us before the competition, this is a building year. We know we're going to start slow. A third of our scores come from freshmen, and yet they have to build into a great team by the end of the season. As we turn back over to floor, Abby Stack for Georgia.
Triple twist, good start.
That was a great triple twist.
Looked easy.
Stack is a senior out of Matthews, North Carolina. Thank you.
Now that's a first.
That's great.
You've got to have a good sense of humor to pull that off. Have some fun with it. Oh, have fun.
Suzanne Yachtman said one of our goals is to make our floor routines more entertaining. Well, that did it.
One of my favorite movies, Chariots of Fire. I'll never think of it the same. That's great.
Caitlin Sullivan now to the beam for Alabama. Brittany McGee off to a great start, as you mentioned, Kathy Johnson. Clark, 9.825 is a terrific start for the team ranked number one in the country on this event.
Certainly showed off her flexibility early in the routine. Several aerial moves.
Talk about building to a final great team by the end of the season. 2008, they were the regional champs with a score of 197.3, a huge score. So even though they're very young this year, they're expected to start a little slow, but be a top contender by the end of the season.
They have a nice combination of experience and newcomers.
And they're taking on the third toughest schedule in the NCAA this year. Back over to the floor, Hillary Morrow, Abby Stack, with that entertaining routine, scored a 9.8 for their first routine out.
Just 4.8, she is a tiny gymnast on the floor, which gives her lots of room to tumble here. Woo! Arabian double for, oh no, and it wasn't enough room. I shouldn't have said anything.
It's usually the tall ones that go out of bounds. Georgia with a comfortable, nearly a 1-point lead going into the final rotation here. They're smiling and selling this routine to the audience for sure.
Although this was the event that Suzanne was least sure of in terms of hitting. Just landings, and they don't quite have the numbers in yet to be consistent on the landings. But so far, so good.
A lot of teams just to pace themselves throughout the season, they do a lot of landings on soft surfaces, in pits, and on landing mats, and they don't take many hard landings. Remember, this is the third meet in 7 days for the University of Georgia, so that's a lot of pounding on the body. Try to save your ankles to the NCAA championships when you need them.
Good routine, and Georgia tries to finish the routines with harder skills as well.
And we'll be back with her score. We're back inside the Stegman Coliseum, the fourth and final rotation. Alabama on the beam. Ricky Lebegern, the junior out of Virginia. The first two scores for Alabama, very strong on beam. 9.825 for Brittany McGee. Caitlin Sullivan followed up with a 9.8. Lebegern competing on all four apparatus, has two 9.85s and a 9.7 so far today.
She continues to be so solid for this team. Third competition in a row, she's competed the all-around, hit every routine.
Coach Patterson at Alabama instituted two new weekly awards. One is for the performance of the week, and one is for the attitude of the week. And this week, junior Ricky Lebegern and Ashley Priest. Her nice. Performances of the week.
Boy, she so showed such calm and stayed cool when she was a little bit back on that side somersault. Other gymnasts would have panicked a little, overcorrected.
Back to the floor. Grace Taylor gave us a thrill on the beam with nearly a 10. Score for Hillary Morrow. Stepped out of bounds, got a 9.675.
It's so nice to see something different. It's really, really cool to see. And even from both teams, I'm seeing more of a variety in choreography and style of music. It's nice to see. It's refreshing.
Geraldine Stack-Eaton now for Alabama on the beam. The score for Ricky Lebegern before her, 9.875. Hear Elvis in the background. She's not performing to the music
Elvis
of Elvis,
is in the
but the gymnasts get to select their favorite songs that they play in the background when they're doing balance beam, so who knew?
Beautiful jumps.
Sometimes they play the music so loud you think they're almost performing to it.
This is louder than usual.
It's not exactly background music.
Lovely. He's very smooth.
You know, sometimes you see a basketball player who has soft hands around the basket. She has soft feet. She just seems to really has a sense of where the beam is.
She comes in with the beam. It's nice. Very comfortable.
Mm-hmm. So Alabama doing very well on the beam. Their lowest score, a 9.8 over there. Georgia, Cassidy McComb now. Grace Taylor had a 9.875. Georgia in control, no question about it, with nearly a point lead coming into the final rotation.
Too bad.
All right. we'll be back for the score there for Cassidy McComb right after this. Alabama now continuing on the balance beam. Ashley Priest, her teammate Jerilyn Stack-Eaton with a 9-9. Alabama very strong here. You can see why they're ranked number one in the country on this event.
And Ashley has everything it takes to do extremely well in this event. She moves very quickly, very precise.
Alabama only lost two routines from their last year's team that finished sixth in the Super Six at the NCAA Championships. A little bit of a disappointment, and in fact, much of the disappointment came with a weak performance on the beam. They have improved a great deal here.
Gosh, another solid performance. Tiny little hop on the landing, but they are doing so well here on balance beam.
Well, the star of the night, Courtney Coupette, a 9.875 in the vault and two tens on the bars and the beam. What's next, Kathy?
And of all events, when you're talking about two ruptured Achilles tendon, to be able to tumble, block so hard to get yourself up in the air for these difficult tumbling skills. Look at that, and a great landing. To the collegiate level, some gymnasts would have just called it quits. Unbelievable.
What a treat. We'll be back with the score for Courtney Coupette and the final two performances right after this. And we're back inside Stegman Coliseum here on the campus of the University of Georgia. Jay Clark, the associate head coach, will now step up to be the head coach. Congratulating Courtney Coupette, her score a 9.95 to cap off a remarkable day for that young lady. Morgan Dennis, the final performer now for Alabama on the beam, and Alabama is spectacular on this event. Their lowest score is a 9.8, and they have a 9.9 from Jerilyn Stack-Eaton. In addition to her national titles in gymnastics, Morgan Dennis, National Honor Society in high school, all of these young ladies are exceptional students, and in fact, the coaches are quick to tell us that these are student athletes, and we're just as proud of their work in the classroom as we are of their work in the gym.
It's very impressive. What's really going to be key to their success this year is the fact that they could come up with these beam performances, meet after meet, but in a situation like this where you're not going to pass Georgia. Georgia is really knocking it out of run on floor exercise. But to go for perfection and hit solid every single routine bodes well for the rest of the season.
56 athletes on the Alabama team over the years have earned 127 Scholastic All-American honors, and they're exceptionally proud of those young ladies. They will not be able to beat Georgia tonight because Tiffany Tolnay will cap it off for the home squad. Bad to the bone. How can you go wrong with that?
Down to her little broken one in her foot. Oh, wow, great landing.
Score on the beam for Morgan Dennis. Capped off a terrific performance for Alabama. 9.85 was her score. A 9.675 on vault, came back with a 9.9 on the bars and a 9.85 on the beam. All she has is one tumbling pass left here on the floor. Nice.
Wow, good landing. Oh, and another tough athlete. I mean, she has a tiny little broken bone in her foot. It's not going to get worse, but it's painful. So they give her a shot for competition. She just suffers through the week during training and just lets it hurt. But she was not going to miss this senior year and this experience.
Another spectacular night of gymnastics here in the SEC. Georgia wins by 9/10 of a point over the University of Alabama. Here's the scoring differential. Alabama won by a 10th in vault over Georgia, and then Georgia got rolling, and they won bars, beam, and floor to cap off a terrific night of competition. Kathy Johnson-Clark is now with our star, Courtney Coupetz, and the iconic coach, Suzanne Yocklin. Kathy?
Iconic.
Thanks, Bart. And Suzanne, you have watched your teams year after year for so many years. After vault, and I thought I was expecting bigger and better landings and stuff. Describe how your team came through in the next three events.
Well, we had to go for the bigger vaults tonight. We could have been conservative and had better landings, but we wanted to go for the bigger vaults because it's early in the season and you've got to get the numbers in at some point. So, you know, even though we made some mistakes on vaulting, we had no good landings at all. I was pretty confident in our team on the other three events. As long as they let it go, and they did, and they refocused, then I was pretty confident we could come through strong even after that vaulting.
Well, especially, and I love the way you described Courtney, just a mental giant. Unbelievable. I mean, to come back from the injury that you have, was this your plan?
I don't know if I really had a plan for the gymnastics. I just knew I was going to be back, and I would be part of this team and help them out any way I could.
How important is to be a part of this team and Suzanne's final year of coaching?
It really means a lot. I wouldn't have had it any other way. It's the best way to go, you know, with the head coach, the one that's done everything and helps us through all the times and knows what to do with us. And it's just been an amazing year so far. We've had ups and downs, believe me, already. But, you know, that's what makes it fun. That's what makes it exciting for the end of the year.
Very few gymnasts get to have that feeling of scoring a perfect 10. You just did it twice in one competition. For all those people who don't get to score 10s, tell them what it feels like and how you went after it.
It just feels like you're on cloud nine, I guess. It's just like a relief. And, you know, you do work so hard and you have those routines in the gym and you can only hope to have them out here in competition. And, you know, tonight God was my strength. You know, I had a kind of an off practice the other day and told the girls, you know, it's okay, I'll be good. And, you know, that just shows, you know, what your strength and what his strength can do for you.
Well, it seems like they're all in for 10. Good luck to all of you going into this final season.
Congratulations to the champs, and thank you, Kathy Johnson-Clark. What a night for Courtney Coupetz. She has world championship medals and 2 Olympic medals. 10 times she's an All-American. 2 times the SEC Gymnast of the Week. Probably she'll be that again this week. Suzanne Yocklin calls her a mental giant. There's no question about it. Courtney Coupetz leaves the Gym Dogs to a win. Join us again next week, Alabama vs. Arkansas on ESPN2 on the 15th at 6 p.m. ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports. Thanks for watching. For Kathy Johnson-Clark, I'm Bart Connor.